maybe you definitely do.
Yeah, like everybody that you everybody think that's not going to talk probably.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great.
Yeah, I would love to meet Oprah. I mean, those are my two. I would be.
Okay.
But I mean, oh, Spike, yeah, the museum.
Okay.
I feel like we're like so tucked in here.
Woman that cannot relate to what she's done with one point or another, and I feel very, very close to that.
Do you think now in that era of the Me Too,
my God, spiritually, to be able to get her strength to become who she is today,
you
just always on your mind. Thank you.
This is Mark Bauer.
Oh my God.
Thank you.
It's gorgeous.
Thank you.
You don't age.
Oh, thank you.
Oh my God.
Like Tina.
Exactly.
Like a huge inspiration. I'm remembering her entering, you know, the music scene. I didn't know, but she was in her 40s at the time. And so to see a woman like that just, you know, crack the code on this whole ageism thing, I think is fearless and inspiring and amazing. And so I'm here to pay homage to that and celebrate.
So you didn't see it yet?
I have not seen it, no.
So what do you expect to feel like seeing Tina on Broadway?
Oh my God. Well, I know I'm gonna be overwhelmed with emotion because of her story, her strength, her resilience, and just again, just her testimony, you know, through it all. But knowing that her faith is what brought her through, I think is what is the message that carries on. Is that if you don't lose your faith, you don't lose your vision, you don't lose perspective, that you can sustain yourself.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
And hopefully I could talk to them as well.
I watched that movie probably like 30 times and 6 years old, which is problematic, but I love it.
Thank you.
Sorry, I'm getting B-roll. I'm so sorry. They're like ready to go, and I'm like, oh,
I'm so sorry.
Spike Lee's back there, and I definitely want Spike Lee.
Love you.
Hi.